Hello and welcome to a very special edition of the English Football Podcast, proudly presented to you by Sport.media. I'm Christopher Chrysostomou, and on the line I have Christian Stojewski, a mad football fan and artist as well. You're basically an artist like Luka Modric, aren't you?
Yeah, a bit of an artist.
Yeah. We'll kick it off. First 20 minutes of the Champions League final, it was all Liverpool. They were the ones attacking. They look, Real Madrid looked shambolic under that pressure, the Jurg press. And then 20 minutes in, the worst possible thing could happen to Liverpool. Mohamed Salah dislocated his shoulder and now looks in doubt for the World Cup.
Shocked that Salah came off the pitch, to be honest. Like, I didn't think it was that bad looking at it. The way he came down, like, he looked hurt, but I thought he was going to come up, get up again, and just a couple of minutes in, he'll start running again, but came off the pitch, dislocated his shoulder, apparently. And, yeah, that's it. It was a night for Salah.
Do you think that Sergio Ramos deliberately went out there to hurt Salah?
I don't think so. I don't think that was his intention. For me personally, I think Salah, it looks like Salah had his arm around Ramos first. You know what I mean? When they were going for the ball, when Salah had the ball, Ramos tried to take the ball off him. It looked like Ramos had his arm behind Ramos, and Ramos just took him down somehow. It was a freak accident. I don't think it was deliberate, honestly. Honest opinion.
Yeah, I agree with you there. I think if you reverse that situation around and Salah takes down Ramos, the social media will be applauding Salah. It's because people hate Ramos. There's a perception that he's a bad guy and that everyone is going against him because Salah's the good guy, the hero, and Sergio Ramos is the bad guy that everyone hates.
Yeah, definitely.
It was a weird final. The first goal, Real Madrid's first goal. What was Loris Karius doing there?
Man with the match.
I don't understand. You're a coach of, is it under 12?
Yes.
Under 12. Your goalkeeper, do you ever tell your goalkeeper to square pass the ball when there's an opposition player standing next to you?
No, definitely not. When Benzema came in from the right, he ran into intercept, obviously. I don't know what went through Karius's mind to throw the ball.
Underarm
throw. It was bizarre. When I saw it, I was like, did this actually happen? Like, the way the ball went in, and then Benzema started celebrating, I'm like, what just happened? Like, I was shocked. I was very shocked to see what happened.
There was a pause there where no one knew if it was allowed. Like, you could score a goal like that. And I was thinking, I don't think I've ever seen a goal scored like that. So it was weird, wasn't it?
Definitely not in the final.
Not in the final. Nah.
Like, and Liverpool players were complaining. Henderson was complaining to the ref. I've got no idea why he was complaining to the ref.
It's not like he's offside.
Nah.
So
not offside. I was shocked to see Liverpool complaining about the goal. I'm like, it's a goal. Goal's a goal. Karius made a mistake. So I'm thinking, but that's it. Ball went in.
It was the most unusual goal I've seen since Nani's goal against Tottenham in about 2010. Do you remember that one where Gomez he was about to kick the ball and then Nani kicked the ball from the spot where Gomez left the ball? Do you remember that one?
Yes, I do. Yeah, I remember that.
It was almost as unusual as that one. Then after that, we saw Mane level the scores 1-1. That was a good header there. I think Mane was probably the only Liverpool player that was the attacking threat once Salah left the field.
Yeah, Mane was definitely isolated. He was the only attacking threat. Firmino was covered.
Yeah.
Most of the game.
And Lallana came on for Salah, but he's more of a player that likes to drop deep and play make through there, so he was never going to be the one to replace Salah on that right wing.
He was a surprising substitution, honestly. I thought they were going to put on a Solanke. Honestly, I thought they were going to play him up front and play with the front three, but they played with Solana. I was shocked.
It just shows you the gap between those two teams where Real Madrid can take a player off and then put Gareth Bale on, comes off the bench, while Liverpool, they don't have that depth on their bench to replace a Mohamed Salah, like, even though I don't think any team could replace Salah. Then after Mane's goal, we saw Gareth Bale's overhead bicycle kick. I would say that's probably one of the greatest goals I've ever seen. Do you agree?
I think it's the greatest goal in Champions League history, if I'm honest. It's the greatest goal I've seen in Champions League history.
Just the technique in that. How... He's been criticised during his time at Real Madrid, and the fans haven't really been on his side all the time. But he delivers in big occasions because he was the one that won him that Champions League title against Atletico Madrid a couple of years back.
Correct. I'm surprised he didn't start the match. I'm very surprised they started with Isco instead of Bale. I actually thought Bale was going to start the game.
Yeah.
And when I saw him on the bench, I was very surprised. I just knew. I think Bale was going to leave when the World Cup finishes.
Yeah. Well, he said that after the game. He wants to play.
He needs to start every game. He's that talented to play 90 minutes every game and not come off the bench in a Champions League final, which is ridiculous. I'm very shocked he didn't start.
I'm pretty sure he's played under 30 games this year for Real Madrid, and he's scored about 19 goals before this match. So
which is incredible, but he should be starting more games.
Yeah, well, that's right.
Very shocked he didn't start the game.
And then the final goal to cap off that game was another Loris Karius error, where Bale... It was a great shot where the ball dipped on Karius, but he tried catching it, and the ball went through his hands.
Bizarre. I've got no idea. I've got no comment for that. He's just a bad goalkeeper. I don't think he's just terrible. It's terrible goalkeeping. He's terrible goalkeeping, Chris. Terrible, terrible goalkeeping. I've got no idea what went through his mind. Would you catch that? Would you palm it out?
Well, he said, I heard him after the game, and he said that the ball dipped on him, and he wanted to catch it, and he should have palmed it. He should have tried to just punch it out for a corner. That's what he said after the game. But, well, it's all over now. The game's over, and those two costly errors cost Liverpool because they had an opportunity. Like we said, before Salah got injured, they were the best team. And even after that, they still played reasonably well without Salah, just that the lapses in defence, the Karius mistakes were the ones that led to the goals and won Real Madrid the game.
Definitely. Karius, he'll get sold.
You think he'll be sold?
I'll be very surprised if he stays there. Well, I'll be very, very surprised if he stays in Liverpool next season. He is terrible. Though, given the benefit of doubt, he did really well leading up to the Champions League.
Yeah.
He didn't make one mistake leading up the whole Champions League, every single game. He made no mistake, no errors, but he made two in the Champions League final.
Yeah, on the crucial stage. On the SBS commentary, Lucy Zalich said that is this the fault of the owners who didn't offer Klopp the money required to buy a world-class goalkeeper? I don't agree with that statement because Klopp spent 70 million on Virgil van Dijk and he spent another 40 on Mohamed Salah, so there's money there at Liverpool. He could have bought a world-class goalkeeper if he wanted to, but he didn't. He's been there for 3 years, almost, and in those 3 years, they've always had troubles with their goalkeepers, and he hasn't done anything to change that.
I agree with that. Karius, for me, is actually a decent goalkeeper.
Yeah.
He just made two crucial errors in the Champions League final. That's all it was.
If you were...
And he'll get sold, unfortunately. That's what I think. Klopp didn't look happy at all.
No.
His reaction was priceless, I'd say. He wasn't priceless. It was just bizarre just to see those two errors in the Champions League final. Leading up to it, he did really well. Leading up to the Champions League. In the Premier League, he was doing well. In the Champions League group stage, he was doing well. Knockout stage, he was doing really well. It's just bizarre.
If you were Liverpool, would you consider trying to get Gigi Buffon?
Definitely.
Even though he's about 40 years old now, he's probably got 1 year left?
He can still play. He can still play.
Yeah.
Well, I think he played for another 2 seasons in top-flight football.
On to Real Madrid now. Cristiano Ronaldo, what did you think of his performance?
Below average. Below average. He should have scored that goal one-on-one with the keeper.
That was great.
In the second half.
That was a great save there by Andy Roberts, though.
Yeah, it was, but he should have still scored.
Yeah.
Best player in the world should be scoring those goals.
He's not the same player, is he, that we saw a couple of years back? He's not the same player since that European Cup final where he injured himself. I don't think he's got the same movement or speed anymore. And he's playing more centrally because I don't think he could track back down on the wings anymore to help out in defence, even though he really did. But I think now the team's built around him staying in the centre, and the players around him now have to do the work, the defensive work.
Yeah, I think so. I agree. I honestly don't think Ronaldo wants to defend.
No.
His attitude just shows me, in that game as well, in the final, doesn't want to defend. Just wants to attack, score the goals, be the extent of attention, and that's it. That's Ronaldo.
That was their third Champions League victory in a row now. That team's starting to get old now, the Madrid team. Players are over 30. I know their defence, three of the four defenders are over 30. Do you see them continuing their dominance in the Champions League, or do you think that this is the final one and we'll probably see the likes of the Juventus and Barcelona, even Liverpool, now take over that spot as the number one teams in Europe?
It's a tough one because it depends who Real Madrid buys. Honestly, I think it depends who Real Madrid buys next season. But Bale's gone. I see Bale leaving. I see a couple other players maybe leaving also. Yeah. They've got an old squad now, and I think they will still be dominant in the Champions League, in their league. But I see definitely Bayern Munich, Juve, Madrid, Barca, Man City, Liverpool dominating in the next 10 years, definitely.
Yeah.
With the money they have, definitely.
All right, thanks for that, Christian. Before we leave, do you want to give a little shout-out to your company, Blase?
Yeah, definitely. Jump on blaseart.com for all artwork that I've posted up. Prints, originals, commission pieces even as well. Go on my Instagram, Facebook, Twitter. Yeah, check it out.
We'll put links to that on the podcast. You reckon you're going to do a Loris Karius drawing?
Should I?
I reckon do a Karius one. I'm sure some Liverpool fans would like to buy one of those. All right, thank you for your time, Christian, on being on the English Football Podcast.
Thanks, mate. Thanks for having me.